TV. Hacky sack.
Yes, hacky sack.
Oh no, they're all brainless.
Hi, Raz.
Vernon, you're okay.
Yeah, we're great. Me and my pals Kitty and Frankie are just hanging out telling stories and watching the boob tube.
TV!
Vernon, look at them. They're zombies.
It did seem kind of weird when they let me get this close to them. And then they didn't mind when I talked all through the show. Kitty even agreed to go on a date with me, more or less. We're gonna play hacky sack.
Keep an eye on them, Vernon. I'm gonna go figure out what's causing this.
Roger that, Raz. Did you ladies know one of the bloodiest battles of the Civil War was fought on the shore of this very lake? Yep, it's true. It happened back when this place was still an Indian summer camp and burial ground. A group of Union soldiers got separated from their regiment. Night was falling, and they were cold and scared of Dracula. Boo. I'm kidding. They were just terrified of getting shot. Though I'm sure any of them with any sense were afraid of Dracula too. They stumbled across an old building. You could still see it on the far side of the lake. So they decided to spend the night there. Little did they know, it was an abandoned Indian insane asylum built on a caveman burial ground. Yep. Little did they also know that a cursed fish lived in the asylum, and that he was an escaped lunatic, but from a different asylum. So even though he was actually living in an asylum, he was still counted as escaped. And what was his curse, you ask? Where his gills should have been? He had hooks. Yup, and where one of the hooks should have been? He had a lung. Yup, a lung. And instead of being about 14 inches long, he was 10 feet tall. But that wasn't the scariest thing. The scariest thing, the absolute scariest thing, and the thing that still makes the old-timer's blood turn to ice and vice versa, is the part I said first about how he had hooks for gills. Oh, brr. Anybody need a hug? Anybody? No? Okay then, anybody mind if I tell that story again?